1995年。
I think the last record, Unbreakable, was to us a transition, trying to get back to what we were known for, the Backstreet Boys, signature sound of being pop R&B. The record before that, Never Gone, was the record that we took after having a couple of years off, from, you know, our things of being at the height with the Millennium and Black and Blue. And in that time frame, I think we were all still, you know, experimenting with our sounds. That record actually went into a little bit of a pop rock direction, which we enjoyed. I mean, at the time it was great. We felt like it was, you know, the direction that we felt like was right for us. But as we were doing it, we kind of noticed that when we took the record to the stage, it really limited the true Backstreet Boys, you know, signature shows that we used to have with the dancing, the choreography, and just like, you know, a lot of entertainment, because it was more rock sounding. It was kind of hard to dance to, so most of our choreography ended up having to be on the previous older songs. So we decided with Unbreakable, we wanted to kind of, you know, start testing the waters again, getting back to more of that pop R&B sound, and now we were able to finally do that with this record here.
Well, yeah, I mean, we all listen to the radio, you know, all the time. We're always downloading new songs or listening to what artists are doing nowadays. But, you know, it was several years ago, I think, you know, that the music kind of changed to that electro dance type, you know. But the funny thing is that you have to go back. You have to go way back to the Backstreet Boys' first couple of records, because that's what music was back then. Getting back to that, I think that's why this record is called This Is Us, is because we have come full circle back to that dancey, urban, pop, clubby type feel. So
in the heart, we wanted to, on this record, really explore and push the envelope, really try to work with some people we hadn't had a chance to. I mean, we definitely worked with Max Martin on one of our songs, because we still feel like we're really relevant to pop music and pop radio. So, it's, you know, as you, in order to get in that style, we felt like we wanted to work with people who are already in that same vein.
When we were on tour,
yeah,
we were literally on the last record. We were on tour talking about, like in the middle of it, talking about producers that we had on the top of our list that we wanted to work with, and setting goals that we wanted to accomplish, and we have. And so that was the period that we had done it, and it's amazing to see it come to life, because
we actually Nick actually reached out to Red One, who's the writer and the producer of the song, who's done a lot of stuff with Lady Gaga as well as Sean Kingston, and he's huge in all of Europe and Stockholm. And we all reached out to him, and he was excited about it. He's really into it. We sat down with him, talked to him for a minute, and kind of told him what kind of sound we were going with and the direction, and he came back with three really great songs, and one of them happened to be Straight Through My Heart, which we looked like really as a group, as well as Jive, the first single. You'll see a lot more dancing. We're in dance rehearsal as we speak right now.
Yep.
We'll be back in tomorrow.
Eight life.
I mean, out of the 11 or 12 songs that we have on the album, I'd say 8 of them are all up-tempo. Well, I mean, bigger is a love song. You know, when you talk about in and out of a relationship, the ups and downs of what a relationship is, how relationships can get tedious sometimes, and you focus on the bad instead of the good. And what the song is talking about is that person is bigger than you, because they can put their pride aside, they can put their feelings aside, and do what's best for the relationship. So that's what bigger is about.
It's a really cool dance up track, up tempo type song. It's kind of like, I think, where we kind of started getting into the more electronic kind of dance sound of the record. It was probably one of the first ones that came that style, and then later on came Straight Through My Heart and Red One. So me personally, I kind of look at Bye Bye Love as the initial start of where we kind of started going into that direction of the dance up tempos.
It's a magical song. I'll never forget, like, being in the studio and as we were recording the song, Wyclef Jean had come in and he had listened to the song and he just sat back in the chair and he's like, I don't know what to say. You know, this is gonna change the face of music. It's something along the lines of that. And he just threw his hands up and he was shocked. So anytime that song comes on, it's so special, and that's also the reason why we named the album This Is Us.
He was kind of fun to work with. He was very interesting to work with.
They created it.
He's a really young guy, very, 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 very talented, and he likes to have fun when he works. You know, he's in there. He's very, very creative. He's a musical genius. And we did two songs with him. She's a Dream and a song called Internationally. And we'd love to work with him again and actually do a proper duet with him next time.
It's really cool because the track of this song is quite different than what the melody of the song is doing. It has a really high chorus, so we're singing in falsetto. But again, it's a relationship song. It's talking about a relationship being undone, per se. Talking about how you're in and out of, you know, I thought I couldn't live without you. I thought I couldn't die without you, like eat without you, do all these things. But we're technically undone, like moving on. So it's one of my favorite songs on the record because of the track and the melody. Straight through my heart. We've already choreographed Straight Through My Heart. We've also choreographed.
Re-choreographed
Backstreet's Back.
Tomorrow
we're starting on This Is Us. And so we've got the next few weeks of hot dance rehearsals.
Hot.
Hey, we're the Backstreet Boys. We want to send a message to all of our Japanese fans. Thank you guys so, so very much for your continued support over the Backstreet Boys for the past 16 years. Coming to Japan is always something very, very special for us. Our live shows there are always packed out, and the support is just is great. We're very, very thankful for you guys. Continued support in the future, and we will see you guys on tour very, very soon. We're coming there, actually, to do some promotion for the brand new record called This Is Us. So thank you guys. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. We'll see you very, very soon.
Thank you.
Backstreet Boys のインタビュー